Good morning, students. So today we have to see the kingdom Plantes classification. Okay, so first of all we will discuss the features of kingdom Plantae. So Plantae is the plant kingdom which contains all the green plants on the earth, or we can say the plants, because certain other types of chlorophyll is also present, pigment is also found in the plants. They are multicellular, plants are multicellular, and their cells are eukaryotic. They contain a rigid structure around the cell membrane, and that rigid structure around the cell membrane is known as cell wall. We have already seen the difference between the plant cell and animal cell in the first chapter. And then plants have a green colored pigment which is known as chlorophyll, and this chlorophyll is required for the photosynthesis. Why? Because this chlorophyll is capable to trap the solar energy. So just like the cylinders, LPG cylinders in your kitchen, which is storing the energy which is helping us to cook the food, so in the same manner solar energy is stored in the chlorophyll, and this chlorophyll storing the solar energy will be required or used for the process of photosynthesis. Now we have to see the classification of kingdom Plantae. So kingdom Plantae is broadly classified into cryptogams and phanerogams. Okay, so what is the literal meaning of cryptogamy? Crypto, it means hidden, and gamy term is coming from gametes. Okay, so gametes are the reproductive cells which helps or which takes part in the process of reproduction. So when the gametes are hidden in the kingdom Plantae, such plants will belong to cryptogams, and when the gametes are not hidden, then such plants are known as phanerogams. Okay, simply we also say cryptogams as lower group of plant kingdom and phanerogams as higher group of plant kingdom. So cryptogams or lower group of plant kingdom is divided further into three categories, that is thallophyta, bryophyta and pteridophyta. And phanerogams is divided into two categories, that is gymnosperms and angiosperms. So we will discuss one by one about the thallophyta, bryophyta, pteridophyta, gymnosperms and angiosperms. And angiosperms is also further classified into two sub levels, that is monocots and dicots. Okay, so let's start with thallophyta now. Before going into this classification, we can also classify the plant kingdom into two groups on the basis of vascular plants. Vascular, it means the xylem and the phloem vessels. On that basis, we can divide the plant kingdom into two categories, that is non-vascular plants and the vascular plants. So non-vascular plants will not have or will not require such developed xylem or phloem or the vascular bundle, because the size of the plant is very small. So in that situation, the food, water or nutrient can be easily distributed by the process of diffusion. So there will be no such requirement of vascular bundle in such plants. An example of these is the thallophyta and the bryophyta, whereas the vascular plants will be well developed. Okay, will be larger in size, so that is why they will require the vascular bundles in the form of xylem, phloem and cambium. So such plants will be known as vascular plants. So vascular plants is further classified into two categories, that is plants without seeds and plants with seeds. So plants without seed is pteridophyta, and the plant with seed is gymnosperm and angiosperm. So we can say that thallophyta and bryophyta is the non-vascular plant, whereas pteridophyta, gymnosperm and angiosperm is the vascular plant. Now next is, in detail we have to see the thallophyta. The thallo term is coming from thallus. Okay, so thallus, it means with in a structure in which you cannot differentiate its different parts. Okay, so and phyta, it means plants. So thallophytes are autotrophic. So when they are belonging to kingdom Plantae, naturally they will be containing chlorophyll, and when they are containing chlorophyll, they will be able to do the process of photosynthesis, by which they will prepare their food by their own, and that is why they are known as autotrophic. But what you are observing here in this picture, the root, stem and leaf is not completely differentiated. Okay, and these plants is basically, or these plants are found in water, so they are completely aquatic. Now the next group of cryptogams is bryophyta. Bryophyta is also known as amphibian of the plant kingdom. Now why it is known as amphibian of the plant kingdom? Because these plants will be found on the places where there will be the connection of the water and land. So you must have seen on the boundary walls where there is the connection of water, either through the taps or any other surface, on those walls there is a green velvety covering. So that green velvety covering is what it is, mosses, and mosses belongs to which group of cryptogams? That is bryophytes. So bryophytes, as they are green, they are containing chlorophyll, so they will be autotrophic, but they don't have a true root, true stem and true leaf. They have the root like structure which is known as rhizoids. So functionally it will be similar, but structurally it is not similar to true roots of the plant. In the same manner, a stem like structure in case of bryophytes it is known as collet, and leaf like structure present in the bryophytes is known as phyllets. Okay, now the next group of pteridophytes is cryptogams is pteridophyta. So pteridophyta is including all the ferns. So here the plant is well differentiated into root, stem and leaf. These plants are non-flowering, they don't bear flower. Here the leaf is divided into small leaves which is known as leaflets, and at the back surface of the leaf you are observing sori. These bulged region is known as sori, and these sori are filled with spores, and the spores are helping in the process of reproduction for these plants, and they are vascular. Pteridophytes are vascular. Now the phanerogams is divided into two categories, that is gymnosperms and angiosperms. What does gymnosperms? Sperms, it means seeds. So when the seeds are naked, not covered by the fruit, such plants are known as gymnosperms. So they will be non-flowering. Here the seeds are not enclosed inside the fruit, and the male and the female cone is present on different plants. Okay, the male cone will produce the male part, that is the pollens, and female cone will produce the ovules, and this is how they will take part in the process of reproduction. These plants are completely terrestrial, and the plants will be in the form of trees and shrubs. So here is the example of gymnosperm, that is cycas, and this is the cone, male cone, or the female cone will be like this. Then next is angiosperms. Angiosperms are the most abundant group of plants. Okay, it means out of 10 plants, if you are observing around yourself, 8 to 9 plants will be the angiosperms. And it is the most advanced group of plants. It is flowering, root, stem and leaf is well differentiated, seeds are enclosed inside a fruit, and maize is the example of angiosperms. Now the angiosperms are classified into two subcategories, that is known as monocots and dicots. So as the mono, it means one, di it means two, cots it means cotyledons. So in the seeds chapter we have already seen what is cotyledon. So monocot plant will have one cotyledon, dicots plants will have two cotyledon. Okay, in monocots plant the seed will be the leaf will be narrow, whereas in dicot plant the leaf will be broad. Okay, the type of venation in monocot is parallel venation, and the type of venation in dicots is reticulate venation. Network like, it means what is it? Reticulate, reticulate venation. In case of monocots, the vascular bundle is scattered. So when the vascular bundle is scattered, you cannot observe the growth in the thickness of the plant, whereas in dicot plants the vascular bundle is arranged in the form of ring like structure. Okay, flowers found in the monocot will be in the form of multiple of the petals will be in the form of flower parts will be in the form of multiples of 3, and here in case of dicots the flower parts will be in the form of multiples of 4 or 5. Then what about the roots? The monocots will have the fibrous root system, okay, and the dicots will have the tap root system. Very simple example of monocots is what? Gramineae family, all the grasses belongs to monocots. So if you pull out the grass, you will observe the fibrous root system, okay, whereas the dicot plants is having the tap root system. Okay, so this is all for today. Your homework is to write down the features of plant kingdom, then this table you will draw. Leave this, but for your understanding, non-vascular and vascular plants you can identify. Then write down the characteristic feature of thylophytes with 2 examples. In the same manner, write down the characteristic feature of bryophyta with 2 examples. Write down the characteristic feature of pteridophyta with 2 examples. Write down the characteristic feature of gymnosperms with 2 examples. The same manner, characteristic features of angiosperm with 2 examples, and differences between monocots and dicots, and why bryophyta is known as amphibian of the plant kingdom. Okay, because they are found on the places where there is the connection between the land and water. This is all for today. Thank you everyone. Your syllabus for unit test is the flower and the seed chapter. This 5 kingdom classification, whatever we have done, it will be, the questions from this chapter will be asked in the final term. Thank you all.